Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make an animated background for your Keynote slides. So I was recently giving a presentation and I had a welcome screen up as the first slide on my Keynote presentation. Something kind of like this, except I didn't want to have a static background. It was kind of boring. I thought it would be more interesting, more modern, if it was kind of an animated looping background. So it turns out it's pretty easy to make these and very easy to use them in Keynote. So I'm going to do it here using iMovie because you probably already have iMovie on your Mac, or you can download it for free from the Mac App Store. You can also use something like Motion or Final Cut or an Adobe product, all sorts of things to create these animated backgrounds, and even download some that already are online. You can search for them. But that costs money, and all those apps cost money as well. So let's do it in iMovie. So I'm going to create an iMovie project here. And I'm going to go straight to backgrounds. And there are a bunch of different backgrounds that iMovie has. Some of them are already animated. Three that really work for this are curtain, underwater, and blobs. And I'm going to use blobs. I think it's a very versatile one. I'm going to drag and drop it here into the timeline. I'm going to adjust the timeline so I can see more of it and stretch the edge so it's a minute long. Why 1 minute? Well, 4 seconds would be too short. People looking at it would notice that it's looping. A minute is plenty long enough, but it's also not going to create a huge file. So the one thing I don't like here is the color. I don't want to be stuck with this red and yellow color all the time. I want to be able to adjust that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this slider here. I'm going to click on the color tools here. And I'm going to use this slider to desaturate it. So now I have a grayscale set of blobs that I can colorize inside of Keynote. So let's export, share, and file from the file menu. I'm going to use full resolution. 720 may work for a lot of things. I'm going to use high quality. You may want to go with best and better quality compression. And I will save it out as slide background. So now back in Keynote, I'm going to drag and drop that file onto the slide. I had saved it here to the desktop, so I'll drag it in. And it's going to appear on top of all my text. So with that video selected, I'm going to go to Arrange and send it to the back. So next thing I'm going to do is, with it still selected, I will go to Format Movie. And I will change it from Start Movie on Click, turn that off. I'll change it to Repeat. I can either have it loop or loop back and forth. Loop back and forth actually works kind of nice because it'll go forwards and then backwards, so there won't be a dividing line of when things suddenly snap back to the beginning. And now if I play, I can see it in action. Now how about coloring it in? So to color it in, I'm going to create a shape. I'm going to put a square there and drag it so it's full size. I'm going to send it backward so it's behind the text but in front of the video. And now under Format Style, I can change its opacity to something like 50% or even less. Let's do 35%. And then I can change its color to whatever I need. So let's change it to a kind of teal color there. And now when I play, you can see I've got a colored background. So I can change the color of that shape on top of it to make it a different color, and that works really well. So now I can create a bunch of these. I can create the underwater one, I can create the curtains one, I could go into another app and create more there or download some online and have a variety of them that I can use on these opening screens. I can also use them on closing screens. Usually those are up for a while at the end of a presentation too.